Well, it looks like after a pause of some 3 weeks, we finally had another piece of news come out about the Coleman murders. And it looks like they're going to have an inquest after all. They're going to have an inquest either because they found something, or they didn't find something, or they don't want anybody to accuse them of not having an inquest because to hide something. So there you are. It's a tie. It's a draw. Any case of this magnitude should have all their papers and have all their procedures and not skip anything. This is Blondie, by the way, and she has fans. Let's see here. We have we found out that the house was going into foreclosure, and this is not surprising. Why would you keep on making payments on a house that you don't intend to live in? Besides that, you signed it, you tricked your wife into signing off to you. So any windfalls that come that your way because of going into foreclosure, you get to keep. So anyway, there's lots of funny little things going on about these mortgages that are in default, and there's ways to make money on these things. Hey, come on, Pia. No, don't do that. So we're learning that Chris Coleman's father, Ron Coleman, asked for donations or contributions to a bereavement fund. And Sherry Coleman's parents are up in arms saying, where is this money going? Is it going back to Chris Coleman to pay for his defense? Remember the last time we talked about it, that it looks like that Joyce Myers and Chris struck a bargain, and that bargain was that she'd pay for his attorneys. I tell you, the silence on this case is so tremendous. It's really the proof of the pudding that Joyce Myers has got her pit bulls out. In fact, I visited a forum on the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, and a man who apparently been a guest on Nancy Grace and is very, very pro Joyce Myers, he was acting as a pit bull, saying nobody should say anything bad about Joyce unless they know her personally and have seen it personally, and blah, blah, blah. And also he listed his parameter. Anybody who says they're not born again is not a Christian. And, you know, gosh, it's been a long time since I've been around anybody that talked like that. You know, what about the people that grew up in a Christian home and there was never any switch, you know, any change? It was just always a part of their lives, you know. Saying grace was as natural as anything, you know. So, but anyway, he is apparently, I'm taking it that between this fella and the moderator, they're both acting as pit bulls for Joyce Myers. And I noticed that everybody went silent once they, you know, showed their stuff. So, good Christian behavior, remember? Let's see, not at the funeral. Wrongful death. Oh, the amount of money that the Ron Coleman, Chris Coleman's father, collected is unknown. Now, if you remember, the acorn doesn't fall far from the tree, and I don't know if you remember that Ron Coleman did some rather strange things for a minister. You know, he wouldn't answer the phone and tell the other family, you know, Sherry's family, they could come and get some stuff, you know, everything. He just stonewalled her and refused all contact. And let's see, what else was there? This may be short. They're really... if I think of something, I'll come back. I should never do these things at night. I'm always kind of weird. Oh, they've got the test results back. They're just waiting for the autopsy report. So, you know, if there is a very high level of some sedative, it would make sense. I mean, I have to laugh. I have to laugh at what these defense attorneys all saying. Oh, they'll have to go for, you know, mental incapacity. My gosh, this guy was planning things down to the T for almost a year. And I think something went wrong at the last minute. I think somebody was, I think Sherry stumbled on some proof of what he was doing. And that threw his original plan all out. And they still have not told us the date of the tickets or the boarding passes that for Sherry Meyer or Joyce Meyer and Chris Coleman and their seats. I think that they have, after 10 years, I think they probably traveled together a good bit of the time and had seats next to each other. I mean, after all, he was 10 years, I think, in her service. So anyway, I'll stop for now.